March of 1958, truckloads of Mennonites came down to Belize. Men, women, and children. The women in their black dresses with their black bonnets, and little children with blonde hair and blue eyes and apple cheeks. They'd lived up in the mountains, huh? You don't see that anymore.
There are some people who came here sometime around 1958.
They were in Holland originally. They went to Germany and they went to Russia. But religious persecution brought them over the side of the world.
What do they believe in?
Yeah.
I can't answer that question, I don't know.
They stick to their culture and they stick mostly to their own people.
They do farming, raising pigs, chicken, corn, peanuts, beans, whatever. They are farmers.
They have furniture to sell out there. They bring down their furniture from where they live.
They are very friendly people. They just don't like their pictures taken.
They speak an old German language called Hutten. Guten Tag is good day. Guten Morgen is good morning. Guten Abend is good evening. Bitte schön. And danke schön.
Jawohl.
Oh, voilà. Aha!
Man, I'm some of the most hardworking, most productive people that we've seen enter this country for since forever. They don't commingle with the local people. If they choose to marry within their own race and within their own community, that's their choice and their prerogative. We shouldn't try to force them into other than that. They have managed to come in and they have carved out their own niche, and they are surviving, being profitable, and being productive to the society as well. And I think they need to be admired, and a lot of Belizean people do good to take a page from the Mennonite book. We could learn a lot from them.
I was amazed to discover that Belize is home to a Mennonite community. I have lived and worked in the Caribbean for over 30 years, making films that explore the rich and diverse culture of the region, but I had never heard of a Mennonite community in Belize. This documentary looks at the history of the community and is a personal record of the many Mennonites I met while making this film.
Mennonites are a religious group. They're a group called the Anabaptists, originated in Germany along about the time the beginning of the Reformation.
The name Mennonite is driven from Menno Simon. Menno Simon was a Catholic priest, and he left the Catholic Church and joined the Anabaptists. And then he became a leader, a great leader amongst the, in Holland and in the German area there. And they were called after him, Mennonites.
They have been from one country to another for many, many years, and they came to Belize in 1958, a group of them, out of Chihuahua, Mexico. Prior to that, they had been in Canada and some in the United States. Before that, they were in Holland, and before that, in Russia, and back to Germany.
Well, I happened to be in the first load to Belize City. Not a very nice ride, and it got humid, hot, and we were not used to that because we came from Chihuahua, Mexico. It was March. And Belize City welcomed us warmly. And then we hired two trucks to take us to Spanish Lookout. And there was no crossing, just the river was shallow. I took off my shoes and went through ahead. It reached me all the way up here.
The leader said, God sent us to this place. This is our new home, and this is where we're going. And they were across the river. There was nothing but a great wall of jungle. There was nothing to see over there. Except in one little corner, there was a rotting down sawmill building. And that's where many of them slept during the night. And during the night, a lady had a baby under a tree there. 2 weeks later, a young girl died in the river. And she was buried over there. And so the Mennonites were home. They had a baby born, they had a funeral, and so they were home. And they've been home over 40 years now.
What do they believe in? What are their, some of their beliefs and practices?
Well, they're a Christian sect, a fundamentalist Christian sect, that for many years would not drive automobiles or even tractors. And however, certain groups of them have changed their ideas. There are Mennonite communities now as far south as the Toledo district. They're in Orange Walk and Shipyard in Blue Creek and in a place called Little Belize. And there's the Pilgrimage Valley group, the Barton Creek group, the Springfield group. They're all around the place. You will run into a lot of them. They have doctrinal difficulties with each other from time to time. Some of the more conservative groups still, they don't even believe in having their pictures taken, you know. That's contrary to biblical teaching according to their lights. And rubber wheels on tractors is not sinful, but it could be an occasion for sin. It would allow the young men to get to town quicker. The Spanish Lookout Mennonites are now drive pickup trucks and have cell phones and email addresses, and they're on the internet. And, you know, they're going business, and lots of business.
Well, my parents are Canadians. They moved from Canada to Mexico in 1958. They moved from Mexico to Belize, which was British Honduras. I was about four and a half years. I started with nothing, started to work for my uncle. Finally, he gave me a share in the business. That's how he grew up. There's a lot of different Mennonites. I mean, I would say we're about probably in the middle. There's even some that will wear different clothing and jewelry and all of that, which we don't believe in. And there's this type which only believe like driving horse and buggy and so on. So there's a big gap, and there's a lot of different churches in there.
And this is your wife? And
yeah, that's my wife and my family, yes.
How many children do you have?
13.
Seven young
Seven girls and six boys.
This is the youngest?
Six, yeah. Baby.
This is the baby?
9 months.
And so this is the last one, you think? What do you think?
Well, I don't know. Maybe we can get another one.
I mean, do you see yourself as a Belizean?
I'm born in Canada, but I'm Belizean now. I still have my Canadian passport, but I can live for all my life here. No problem.
But are you a Belizean?
No, I'm a Mexican. I born in Mexico.
Do you still see yourself as a Mexican?
Yes, I speak Spanish better than English.
So you're not a Belizean?
No.
And your wife? What is your wife?
Same.
She's a Mexican?
Mexican, yeah. You got a Mexican passport. You got a resident of Belize only.
Okay. And so we have two Mexicans and a Canadian. Is that right?
Yeah. But we all live here like Belizean. No, I don't have no car. I have a buggy and I have a horse.
Why? Why not a car?
Well, that's what the religion have.
They won't allow anything modern. For instance, there's no cars, there's no tractors, there's no audio or video software, nothing like that, or no electricity. And so, yeah, they're just basically, they choose to live like people lived 200 years ago.
They have used the iron wheels on tractors.
Why don't you have rubber wheels?
It's too much go with the world. Too much worldly machines. They keep the steel wheels because it can traveling more slower. No get at having business what the world have.
Things like television. Do you have television?
No. Not any music.
No music?
No.
You sing?
Yes.
Why no music?
Well, that's what my father don't show me any music. Our church, we don't have nothing, no music. Just sing by voices, four voices, and it sounds better than music.
And what language is the service in your church?
In Low German.
Not English?
Sometimes when we have English visitors, we speak some English in church.
And in Little Belize?
No.
Only German?
No, only German. Hi.
Why did you leave Canada?
Because my father don't like the cars and trucks. He liked horses.
When you arrived here, what work did you do?
Try to clean the bush. I mean, clean the field, to plant corn and so.
What business are you into today?
Today?
Yeah.
I'm sleeping.
There's a cup.
My business is furniture.
Tell me how you go about doing this.
You see the lumber work we have here? We cut it and put it together and prepare it to Belize and sell it right there.
But are you going to continue to live in Belize, or do you want to go to Canada, or what do you think?
No, we went to Canada, it was 3 years ago. We went to visit. I have my sister there, and I don't like it too much here. I want to stay here. Mm-hmm. No one to go back to Canada.
Do you consider yourselves now Belize citizens?
I have a Belize passport, I have a Canadian passport. I have both.
And you have?
Mexican.
And Belize?
No.
No, Belize. I know. I am Mexicano.
Es Mexicano. No entiendo español. No hablo español.
I can't talk Spanish.
No, I'm a Spanish.
You speak Spanish?
No.
So you're a non-Spanish speaking Mexican?
I was 8 years when my parents come from Chihuahua, Mexico.
So tell me, how did you get here?
You want me?
How did you meet him? How did you meet him?
I meet her.
Where?
Right by my brother.
In Shipyard?
Yeah. She worked for my brother.
How many children you have?
11.
They are what, boys, girls? How many boys, how many girls?
Six boys and five girls.
And you have grandchildren? How many?
Seven.
Seven or all?
Fief and Fire. But son, you might have line half, you might have Fief and line half Fire. That's nine.
Nine?
You sure?
Yeah, I think you're a little bit crazy.
Do they have non-white people as Mennonites?
They have only white people Mennonites. Yeah.
So no Creole people, Negro people, Garifuna?
No.
It's not allowed or what?
Well, they can't talk German at all.
So you have to talk German to be a Mennonite?
Who? Like your niggers?
Nee, when they hear that language, we don't know if they can talk.
Oh, you mean...
Are you allowed to become a Mennonite if you're not...
Oh, if we allowed...
Yeah.
No.
Why?
Because we have our own religion.
What is the religion? Because I'm still a bit confused.
Well, we don't like to marry with black people.
What else?
We like... married with our people.
Okay. Can you change things in your church? Can you change the law?
No.
What about Barton Creek? Are they the same as you?
A little different. Like, we work with engine, like the furniture. And they use only horses for it.
Then they have long beards.
Oh yeah, I don't like that. Oh no. I like very smooth. Like you.
You have television here?
No.
What do you think about television?
It's not
children
good.
Children see too much bad things.
Like what?
Like killing people and all that.
Have you ever seen television?
And Belize, he looked.
Did you like TV? You don't like cartoons? No?
I don't know what's that.
You don't know what a cartoon is? No. So you never watched a whole show on TV?
No.
Would you like to watch television?
Not too much.
How do you dress your children?
She's sewing.
Yes. I make this and this.
So you make all your own clothes?
All self?
All mine. For the family.
Is it good that they all look the same?
For me, yes.
Why?
Both are, hey?
As good as all in the line, lad.
Sure.
Why not?
But they have no individuality. They are all wearing the same thing, the same hat, the same...
Yes.
Why?
That's what I like.
Why?
That's the law. Because all the Mennonites have it like that.
What happened to Doc Friesen? Why isn't he part of the church?
He no one to know. He went out of the church.
Why? What did he do?
He don't like that we what we have.
What did he do wrong?
Well, he have a different mind, you know. He have a bad mind.
My name is David Friesen. So in my professional, that's farming, dentistry, pharmacy, and in general, medical. So I do it for 26 years here in Belize.
Do you ever deliver babies?
Yes, I have delivered 2,061 babies now.
Who are the people you look after?
50% Mennonites and 50% Mayas.
You were a very strong member of the Mennonite community in shipyard, but yeah. I hear there were some problems.
They never agreed if I work with the Mayas, and they never allow me to make a meeting with the people. And then very soon, they excommunicate two of my sons, excommunication completely.
Traditional church, they always want to keep people away from the Bible, and we want to study the Bible directly, and we want that everybody understands the Bible, not just the leader of the church.
That's something that the minister don't agree with that. And I can't agree it in this way. So after all of that, in about 2 years' time, so they excommunicate me also. That means that you can't go to any church visit. You can't eat with anyone together who is a member of the church. You can't buy anything from him. They can't visit you. You are out of anything. About 20 families there who were excommunicated for that reason.
They like to live in traditions life, and I want to live the modern life. I want to be I am a Christian and not a traditional church member.
Are you still a Mennonite?
Yes. Well, I am a Christian. I know Mennonite. Mennonite is history.
The old Mennonite church, they never was in that way in years ago. But after all the years, so that became nearly a dictator.
They want to be to have just one ruler to rule the community. And I have my opinion is everybody have their own rights to make decisions. They have a rule that they know how want to have a relationship with the Belizean people. Just in business they will have, but not in spiritual and not in religious in friendship with Belizeans.
No intermarriage?
No.
Do you think that's a form of racism?
I think part of it. They know like the Spanish people, not the black people. And the white one must speak German if they are not. If not speaking German, that means they are Gentile.
They talk about eternal condemning, you know.
And you believe that?
They can't. Jesus could condemn, but not a man.
And your children are not eternally damned?
No. Why? No man on earth could do that. They could kill him, but they could condemn him.
Can you ever see peace happening between the two communities?
That will take time. But the peace has to come later.
Our main language is German, and that's why we worship in German. But at the same time, our children are going more into English, and we're going to start with some more English worship services.
I see no statues, no crosses. How come you don't have any of these things?
Well, if we have the Lord Jesus, we don't need those things. We believe in the God, the unseen God.
How is this church here different from, say, some of the other Mennonite churches in Belize?
We believe that we are free. Living for Jesus doesn't mean that we have all kinds of rules. And that's one difference. Some believe that they can't drive a vehicle. And we think, we know the salvation is not driving a vehicle or driving horse and buggy. Living for Jesus is inside of us.
What about issues like dress?
Our salvation is not in dressing either. Our salvation is in Jesus Christ.
I only saw white people in your congregation today. What is your policy towards this?
We welcome non-whites. The color doesn't say much to us. We believe that God sent his son for everybody. It's not just for the whites. But because we are in an isolated colony where, first of all, just the whites moved in, that's why it is basically white.
Okay, so you could be a Creole person or a Garifuna or a Mestizo or a Mayan and be a Mennonite?
Oh yes, of course. The Mennonite is our belief.
I have come that they may have life and have life to the full.
We try to live a life so that it is attractive to those people, that if they marry our Mennonite people or our white people, that they are attractive to our beliefs, so that they want to be a Mennonite.
What is your aim then?
Our main is to do more mission, so that we will get saved and have got eternal life. And the way we understand, like the Mayan people, they don't have eternal life. They don't have the relationship with God because they have their idols.
So are they living in sin?
We would say yes. According to the Bible, yes.
So you feel you have a duty to convert them?
Yeah.
I see also that you have music in your churches. Is that different from other churches?
Well, for some of them, yes. Especially here in Belize, there are very few Mennonite churches that have music. But we believe that we can worship God with our music too.
I sing a lot. I play guitar. I teach Sunday school at like different times. We drive our vehicles. We have our cell phones, TV, radio.
And what about video games and computer games?
Yes. Yeah, they do that as well.
But a lot of them are quite violent.
Well, we try to watch out what we get them. We don't let them choose movies and games themselves.
But those things aren't sinful?
No.
But a lot of Mennonites say that television is like the devil's machine.
Yeah, I'm familiar with that. But no, our community wouldn't, our church wouldn't believe that was sinful.
How come?
Because we live in a free land, We can live by choice and do things by choice.
What things are sinful?
Like drinking, smoking are considered sinful in our church.
But some Mennonites smoke and drink.
Yeah, that's true. I'm not saying our church doesn't have sin.
If young people want to go to dances and parties, is that allowed?
Dances, our church does not go with dances. But parties, like any party is fine, but not if it's an alcoholic party, then we don't. Like, I'm not saying that nobody does do that in our church, but that's something that wouldn't be acceptable.
So what's wrong with dances?
I don't know. I don't know. It's just something that I guess we didn't grow up with.
But you allow music. Like.
Yeah, we allow music.
Mm-hmm. So you can play music but not dance to it, is that it?
Yeah, I guess.
What's the status of the German language?
I see it fading away. In school, we don't We don't teach German at all anymore. Sad to say. But and in our church as well, it's like our church is slowly going into English more and more.
What about the role of women in the Mennonite church?
Our church has a lot of help from women, like teaching Sunday school. Women have a good part of input in our church.
Are they allowed to be pastors?
No, so far we've never had a female pastor.
What does it mean to you to be a Mennonite?
I'm happy to be a Mennonite. I know that from on the outside we're often looked upon as Christians. I'm happy to hear when outsiders understand that Mennonites are the God-fearing people.
When the Mennonites came here, we imported frozen chickens, about a half a shipload every month. Well, soon after the Mennonites came, we now have all the frozen chickens, all the turkeys that we need for the entire country, and the population has tripled since then.
We are farming turkeys. We supply most of the turkeys consumed in the country in our immediate farm. And our children, our married children, have a share in it. And then we are in the business of sand and gravel, aggregates. We ourselves we like it the old way. My wife sews everything that we wear.
What about things like photography and so on, having pictures taken of one? Is that okay?
That's okay. It wasn't, but it's okay now, yeah.
I don't understand. Why was it not okay in the past and it is okay now? How is that?
That's the point of the religion again. Please ask that question to someone else. Church leaders would know.
What about divorce?
Divorce, it's not practiced in our community very much. It does happen once in a while.
Is it allowed?
It's not allowed. But it still does happen once in a while.
Get enough money to open this restaurant?
We borrowed it in a bank here in the credit union. We have their own credit union here. So we make a loan in the credit union.
This is the Mennonite credit union?
Yeah. Yeah, that's a Mennonite.
What about things like taxes?
Yeah, we have to pay tax. We have to pay sales tax. 8% sales tax that we have to pay.
What about income tax?
We don't pay income tax. But yeah, lots of Mennonites pay income tax, but not.
What you see as being the future for you?
Right now I can't see another way than work in the restaurant.
Are you happy with your work?
Yeah, and I'm not too tired.
And plywood here,
plus el wiring y todo eso sí hay que comprar en Venice, pero el balance creo que vamos a comprar con tablet.
Traditionally, what has happened before is that Mennonites would have stayed within their own communities, but as time goes by, I think things are changing, and the trust that they have with the locals like myself, I think that is what counts a lot, and that brotherhood would come, and that's why we work together. From we were small kids, I think, we know one another.
Yes.
And then it's about 2 years ago that we joined forces, me and Franz and my brother, to form this construction company, actually. Franz, with the vast amount of experience that he has in the construction business, and me putting the input when it comes to the paperwork and sort of things. Basically what we did was to form this company to give to the people of Belize affordable houses. We locals around here in Belize are, well, we work happily with them and we don't have no problem. And it's a plus for us locals because they don't have their vehicles, they have to charter vehicles from the locals, and that's where our job comes in for the locals, you know.
Do you have your own vehicle?
And I have.
Why?
The community now agreed that we have our own vehicle.
It's against their religion to have vehicles. Well, not machine, but vehicles with tires.
So how do you get around in shipyards?
Oh, I have my own buggy with a horse.
Does your buggy have rubber wheels?
They have rubber wheels, yes.
I don't understand. Why can your buggy have rubber wheels and not your tractor?
Well, that's funny. That's really funny. That's a good question.
So, are you allowed to drink beer?
About 2-3. But oh, I don't mind to drink 2 or 3 beers.
What about smoking?
I smoke a lot.
Is that allowed?
Not.
About 3 years ago, we've started selling computers and service and repair computers. Since then, we've started doing internet. We've got a satellite dish that does satellite internet, and now we've got a wireless system that distributing internet to our neighbors here.
You have a website?
SpanishAgot.bz. We've got a business community directory there. We've got some a map on how to get to Spanish Garden and some information on. We have a picture gallery. We have a list of the different churches in Spanish Garden, and that's basically it. Originally, a lot of Spanish Garden people were kind of shy of the computer and the technology, but since or for the last 10 years, it has changed a lot. 25 to 30% of homes in Spanish Gold have internet right now. There's probably about 60 or 70% that have computers, but not all of them are connected to the internet. Businesses, especially, taking advantage of technology, doing most of their ordering over the internet, online. The traditions of the Mennonite people are deeply ingrained. I think they won't go away so quickly. I think the people of Spanish Gold are taking advantage of technology, and I think that's a good thing, and I don't think it will destroy our culture.
I built the whole resort. I've done everything that you see here. I mean, I did the designing and the plumbing, electrical, everything in the house. Like, we built all the furniture. Like, we built the chairs, tables, basically everything. It's we call it turnkey, basically the start to finish we offer. Most of my workers, they come from different parts of the country. There was no development here yet 10 years ago, and from then we've never stopped working on the stretch of beach here. I built the private pavilion for Francis Ford Coppola. I was born and grew up here, and I wouldn't call myself a Canadian, and although I have a Canadian passport, but I'm a Belizean. I never joined the church. Everybody calls me a Mennonite, and I've never been ashamed of being a Mennonite, so I don't mind if they call me a Mennonite or whatever.
They live in community, but they are capitalists. Everybody makes as much money as he can, pays his taxes, obeys the law, but they all live in community. They hold property in the name of the church, so they can't sell their farm to some outsider. It has to be a Mennonite that buys it, or the church takes it over and assigns it to another family.
My parents are Canadians. They came from Manitoba. They lived in Mexico. I was born in Mexico. A big family, and we only had 38 acres of land. And when they heard about Belize, that much land, we came to Belize and started working here. We made lots of mistakes when we came here because everything was different than where we used to live. The weather was different and the culture was different. But we learned, and now we are very happy that we live here.
How much land do you own right now?
Altogether about 8,000 acres. We started planting rice, and we are very successful with the rice. We have done the cattle ranching for the last 30 or 35 years at least. And we're still increasing every year a little bit. And then we do the road building and bridges and land clearing and all different kinds of the jobs we do. What I like the best is the cattle ranching.
Come!
We fill the market here, the Belize market first. And whatever is left over, we sell it to Mexico or to Guatemala. Between all the Mennonites, I think we have about 30,000 head of cattle, close to half. Half of the cattle population.
So what would happen if the Mennonites left Belize?
The local people, I don't know if they would be ready to produce all that.
About how many people do you employ altogether, and are they Mennonites or are they non-Mennonites?
I have some, the mechanics have mostly Mennonites. I have a few Indians here from San Felipe. So I would say maybe 50-50, more or less. And we have sometimes between 30 and 50 people. I don't think we have any unemployment here in Blue Creek. Everybody has a job. If they want to work, they can work. Everybody has a job. I cannot remember one person that doesn't have a job here in Blue Creek.
How would you deal with crime, issues of crime in the community?
Well, we have a good system here. Most people have telephones and radios. And we catch 9 thieves out of 10. If the police is here, we ask them to help. If not, we do it ourselves.
But I thought you're non-violent.
Well, we are not violent, but we have to catch them. We have to protect ourselves.
What is the relationship of the government of Belize and the Mennonites, or especially your activities?
I think very good. I get along very good with everyone. I mean, with Agriculture Department, Minister of Works, I'm happy with that.
Yeah. Did you get any concessions at all from government?
No, I never applied for a concession. A few people did, but I never have done it, no. We build our own roads here. We build our own school. We pay our own school teachers. And we have our own clinic, we pay the nurse, and those things, government don't have to spend money on us here. And that's one benefit I think that the government has here. They don't have to spend that much money on us, like building roads and streets and all that stuff.
But you pay the same taxes?
Yeah, we pay the same tax as other people do, the same rates, yeah. Mm-hmm. One thing for the Mennonites is that they work together. 11 people of us, we bought a plane to spray our field because a plane cost too much for each farmer. So we went together, all together, and we bought a plane. And then we spray for everyone that has a share on the plane. When we go to church, we always learn that we're supposed to help each other, one another. And I think that's the background of it.
All that come here tonight will take something home that will bless their hearts, Lord, and help them to grow in their lives and in their relationship with you, Jesus. I just pray this in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
The church that I go to, we don't really have any dress code or anything, a requirement in that area. We just simply teach our young people is to dress modestly and decently, and that's it. And I think nothing further than that.
But we're going to start tonight with a hymn. And so I'm expecting all of you to sing. So why don't you all get up and help sing this song?
One, two, three, four!
Power to love.
I say we need a little bit. Singing. You got that right, Henry.
What you have seen in this film is only a small sample of the lives of the Mennonites of Belize. As a group, they continue to prosper, especially in the traditional areas of agriculture and construction. But they are also involved with innovative new projects, with one Mennonite running an ultralight plane operation, while oil has recently been discovered on Mennonite land in Spanish Lookout. They have even introduced Canadian hockey in Belize, as the Mennonites, especially the young people, continue to shape the future of the country.
I think one of the coolest things is our community, how we work together and how we serve God together.
To learn more about God and the angels and all the people that care about us.
We go to church and it's about God, and we go to school and we learn about God and just everything. It's really cool.
Mennonites are cool. We have about the best place in Belize to live. That's right.
What is it to do here?
Biking, swimming, hiking, hunting, fishing, having fun. Anything, pretty much.
We have lots of parties. We don't do any bad stuff at the parties. We still enjoy ourselves, I'm sure, more than anybody else ever has in their parties. But it's the dancing. It's not our heritage. We don't really care because we do a lot of other things that for us are more exciting than dancing.
Well, we did rollerblading and we had ramps and we rammed over with the rollerblades. And we went swimming middle of the night in the full moon.
pretty much we can date whenever we want to. It's just up to our parents. Some parents will set restrictions for their kids, but it's not like the elders of the church will come and tell you you're not old enough to date or you're not dating the right person. It's more the parents.
Are you allowed to date boys before you get married?
No.
That's not a problem?
No.
Are any of the young people involved in premarital sex?
I'm sure there's always some, but not known that I could name by name. None of my friends were brought up not to. And I like the way they teach it to us from a very young age. And I know the temptation is still there, but it's pretty deep in us already, I think, that we leave that till we're married.
So what does it mean to you to be a Mennonite?
Proud of it. I don't know. Hard workers. That's basically very proud of my heritage.
How is life here different?
I'm just sure this is the best place to live in the world. Blue Creek. We have bush all around us, which I've grown up in. My dad is a logger. And so much freedom around here. I just wouldn't live anywhere else.
Would you rather be in Canada or the States or?
No.
So what is it like? What is it like in Blue Creek?
It's freedom.
What would you do if somebody came with a gun?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know, I can tell you what I would do.
We just try to love them more to stop the shooting like that.
Think that would work?
Yeah, that works.
You agree completely with your parents? You follow everything?
Sure.
And your children will?
Same thing like we.
No change?
No.
I don't want to live no more under rules. I want to live under freedom.
They're doing well in everything they touch. They're seldom of a failure.
And I'm really a Belizean because I choose to be a Belizean. I paid for my Belizean citizenship.
They are Belizeans. They have been here for long enough. They have made serious contributions to Belize. I consider them to be Belizeans. And so many of them have been born here. They know no other country. This is their home.
I think eventually, in a couple more years, things will change. And what we see right now, shipyard, when you come back, you will see maybe a couple BMWs or something rolling on the streets.